Hi YouTubers, Melissa here with Your Time Training. Thanks for stopping by. Today's routine where you're gonna target your core, really focusing on like the obliques and around like your belly button area. Kind of hard places to target, but I've got some awesome moves for you and you're definitely gonna feel it. But we're working your entire core area, hitting up those abs hard, and we're gonna start on your hands and knees. I want you to have your wrist under your shoulders and your knees under your hips. And I want you to curl your toes under and lift your knees off the ground. Holding yourself here alone is gonna be some pretty incredible work for your core. So let's just stay here and focus on breathing and bringing your belly button up and into your spine. Keeping those shoulders over your wrist. And we're gonna bring your left knee up close to your left elbow and back. And then to the other side. Let's go back and forth through this. Keeping your knees off the ground the entire time. Make sure you're breathing. Keep checking that form. Shoulders over wrists, knees under hips. You can feel how we're really warming up every part of your core right now. Yeah, 4, 3, 2, one more on each side. All right, so we're gonna go back to the similar move, but this time you're gonna kind of take that knee over an angle, leading your knee towards the opposite arm. So get yourself back up, stomach in tight, shoulders are over your wrists, knees are under your hips. And just do a little twist, nothing crazy, and bring it back. Over and down. Keep breathing, stomach in tight. Keep going. Halfway there, 10, 9, 8, 7, last one right there. All right, you know what's working already, right? So I want you down on your elbows now, laying on your tummy. Get those elbows under your shoulders this time and curl your toes and lift yourself into a low plank. Push your heels back, but keep your shoulders over your elbows. Keep your stomach tight, butt down. Don't want your butt up in the air here. Keep it down. You're just gonna tap one knee at a time down to the ground. Down and down. Keep breathing. Nice. You've got two more each side. One and down. All right, go ahead and just stretch yourself out for a second. Keep breathing still and keep that belly button into your spine. All right, so I'll get you back into your high plank. And this time your feet are back. This time you don't have to hold your knees under your hips. What we're gonna do here is just bring your knee over and back. Knee over to the opposite side and back. So I'm taking my feet back out a little wider than my hips. So bring it all the way through. And back. So it's a big range of motion here. And of course, you're going to be working your arms to hold yourself up. Bonus. Keep pulling. Maybe four more. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good news. You're laying on your back. So flip it on over and lay back. Keep that stomach in tight. Now, when I say stomach get tight, even though we're laying down, I just don't want everything like just completely relaxing here. Be aware of the muscles that we just worked because we're going to keep working them. And you want to connect with the muscle that you're working. So go ahead and lift up a leg and put it up, your ankle on your knee. And we're just going to crunch here. Hands behind your head. Every time you come up, exhale. Inhale as you come down. With control. I don't want you just lifting and lowering. And depending on like just your motion to bring you through this, I want you controlling it. With your muscles, up and down. Exhale, keep that chin lifted. Exhale on the lift. Keep going. Two more. Last one, now switch sides. Same thing, nice and slow, lots of control on the way up and on the way down. Just enough to where you're lifting your shoulder blades off the ground. Just a little crunch. Three second right here. Yeah, 3, 2, and 1. All right, next we're switching sides again. This time you're gonna lift and bring everything together. As you're lifting, focus on pressing your belly button into your spine and really exhale. And then bring it back down and stretch it all out. Lots of control on the way down is important too. So bring it up and exhale, and down, stretch it out. Up and exhale, and stretch it out. Again. Just two more here. Last one. And switching sides. Cross it over. Same thing happening. Bring it up. Exhale. And control down. Up and exhale. Control down. Just three more here. 3. Chin to the ceiling. 2. Last one. All right. Both feet down. Take your arms out to the side. You're just gonna lift up, head and shoulders off the ground, chin to the ceiling, and still pressing that belly button into your spine. Keep it lifted here. I want you to take your hands and just bend, not bend, crunch so that you're working your obliques, the side of your stomach, rib cage to hip bone, to touch your left fingertip to your left calf muscle, and just isolate that. So you're gonna squeeze back to center, squeeze. So if your neck is getting sore, take your other hand and just rest it there. Like put your fingertips right at the base of your skull just for a little support. Don't pull. Just give yourself a little break. 4 more here. 4. Keep your shoulder blades off the ground. Chin to the ceiling. Woo. And stretch it back. And other side. So lift it up. Touch the other calf muscle with your fingertips. Squeeze, chin up. Keep going, keep squeezing. 2 more. And nice, all right, so lay back. Reach your arms up. We're gonna do our little crunch up and then do a little lift over. Lift your shoulder off the ground, bring it back and stretch it up. And then go over to the other side and then lift it back up. So I want you having lots of control. I want you to pretend like you got a box in your hands and you're holding it the same distance the whole time. Keep those arms straight, reach back and stretch, lift your shoulder off the ground as you crunch and then bring it back. So I'm taking a minute to explain that to you because we're going to add on to this move. And it's an awesome one if you get that form right. Keep on lifting, reach up, reach over, and back. All right, so keeping that in mind that we just did, take that leg back up, just like our starting move, lift your arms up. We're gonna put a bunch of stuff together here. So you're gonna lift your legs and crunch and reach your arms over. So you're going to reach over that bent leg and then bring it back down, over. Shoulder off the ground, lead with that shoulder, lift the shoulder blade up. Work the muscles that you want to work. It's all in your core. Lots of control. Take the breaks when you need to. Form is more important than anything. Keep going. Give me one more here. We're gonna switch sides. All right, switch it up, reach over, lift, crunch and reach, reach back. Exhale still, don't forget to breathe. Inhale, exhale and lift. Inhale, exhale and lift. Two more here. Last one. All right, arms up, stretch it out. That is the end of that routine. I hope you felt it right away, just like I did. All right, so thank you so much for watching. Obviously, when you're working your core, you're trying to work that midsection, or if your goal is to get a six-pack, you can't just do an ab routine and get that. You've got to incorporate some clean eating, and you must do some cardio. All of that is important, but if you do all these things together and you incorporate this routine, I know you're going to get awesome results. So thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe and share my channel. I'll see you back here next time. Have an awesome day.